This was revealed in a meeting between different stakeholders and the entities held at Kalangala Town Council with an aim of getting feedback on key services in regards to power, safe water supply and ferry services. Amina Namudu, the ERA senior communications officer, explained the process of gathering power tariffs.
It is a process that starts with an application from the company that distributes electricity. The company that distributes electricity submit applications to ERA on an annual basis, requesting ERA to review the tariffs and to consider the tariffs they are proposing in that application. When we receive the application, we engage the stakeholders involved, the leadership of that area, and the public, requesting for their comments on the application, whether they are objecting or they are okay with the tariffs that are being applied for by the company.
She has assured islanders that the tariffs will be reduced since the price of fuel is dropping.
Fortunately, that authority does not lie with us. However, I am aware that the government is doing everything possible to intervene and address the situation. The issue of the prices of fuel are not only affecting Kalangala. However, we also appreciate that considering that the Kalangala plant has a component of diesel, the impact may be big.
First of all, of course, the feedback we have received, of course, it has something to do with the reliability of our services, which we are working on. And again, as the tariff, of course, that is something which will come after this quarter. So to me, according to this current situation, we don't expect this tariff to go, to go higher, because we expect it to drop.
Juliet Najuma Senkole, the resident district commissioner, urged Kalangala Infrastructure Services Limited and the leaders to engage the community members who are more affected.
Public is appealing on the high tariff. So we have been discussing that issue with the other stakeholders. Where there are gaps, the care is to consider the services, because our people don't have enough money.
Area leaders have applauded the entity for their services to the islanders.
Appeal to care. First of all, I want to thank all these people, and I appeal to them, let us work as a team for the common goal of seeing the Kalangala on the top.
If so, of the KIS, they affect us very much, because we find that we use almost 2 million per month. So that means when the power is very high and the costs are very high, we have also to put our prices very high on the radio talk shows, on the radio adverts, which also affects our local customers, like maybe those we have with the small businesses.
Kalangala Infrastructure Services Limited serves over 2,000 clients who use the power both commercially and domestically. Report compiled by Samuel Nkuba for the news.